So you're just gonna start basically wrapping up the room, and as the last thing this year, we thought it would be cool to do an analog version of our online open source design job board, which we have at opensourcedesign.net/jobs. And it's basically, if you have a project and you need design help or a logo, redesign, icons, part-time designer, whatever, like all kinds of different stuff, like UI design, documentation design, you can submit it there. This is basically just an analog version of that. So if you have a project and you need anything design-wise, then please come up and present it. Like, you can just open a tab on my laptop and do it, so we can just do it quick. So first of all, a show of hands, who has a project and needs design help? Okay. Any, like, no worries as well. Like, you can show anything, like any little thing. So each one of you, I want you to come here. And so we're gonna have, like, I don't know, max 3 minutes or something, but you can just show off your stuff. Who wants to go first? Yeah. Oh, and you're also required, basically, after you presented it here, to put it on this page. It says there, you can easily add a job through our GitHub repository. So after you're done here, do that.
But if he just adds it to your laptop, you're gonna get all the kudos.
Oh, but I'm not gonna manage all that.
Deleted, so
oh yeah, sorry, my keys are painted black, so you're gonna have to. I'm very sorry, I'm a real hacker, so.
Where's the question mark?
I don't even know myself.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm Maxime. I'm developing the project Inventaire.io, which is about doing the inventory of your books and sharing this inventory with your friends and communities and discover the books available in your network. So for each book, you can tell if you are lending it or giving it or selling it. No one is selling here, but. And so this is all open source, so it's AGPL3 license. And as much as possible, I try to use open knowledge. That is that I'm a user of Wikidata, so as a slash.
Delete with one too many characters,
huh?
Wait. It's German keyboard.
Oh my god.
Yes.
Slash. I'm sorry, my laptop is not very usable.
Okay, so this is my inventory. So there are things. So let's see. You can see there. That's a book from Asimov, and there you can see the data come directly from Wikidata, and this is the description from Wikipedia. And so if you think that the data there are wrong, you are invited to click there, which gives you brings you to Wikidata, which is the awesome project from Wikipedia to share structured data among Wikipedia. But we, as external developers, can also use it. And it's really awesome, because then you can just go to, it's a graph of data. So here we are on the page of a book, but we have the author.
1 minute left.
Yeah.
Well, where exactly do you need design help?
Oh, yeah, sorry. And so, from the interface, I hope that you can see that I have some sense of UX, user interface things, but I'm not a designer, and I really think this project will need some designer's love. There is no logo for the moment. There are some inconsistencies in the fonts I can see. There is no clear colors scheme thing. So there are a lot of things where designer's love would be really helpful.
Yeah. how to contact you or how to get involved?
You have all my contacts in the footer there. So and so the address is inventaire.io, so it's the basically inventaire like that. So it's the French spelling for inventory. But yeah, because all the domains were taken in the and inventaire.io and max@inventaire.io is my address. And so and it's on GitHub, it's on Twitter, everything.
Cool. Thanks.
Thank you.
And it will be on the open source design job board.
It will
soon.
Be.
Okay, next one. Who wants to go next?
Technical staff, developer, contact manager, and all everything of this. Unfortunately, it's only in Ukrainian for now. It's a Ukrainian-based company, which is online, open online courses and library, interactive books, and everything. And yeah, it's very easy. Probably all of you know edX. Online courses thing, right? And probably you also know that they have, yeah, it's this massive open online courses provider. They also have the OpenEdX, which is basically platform, open source platform that everybody can use for their own online courses project. Which we are using, and who knows the open the edX design can easily see that this is edX design, and as we use open edX for our open courses platform, there are also a lot of people that also uses it, so. Everybody has the same design. So our question is very simple. We need someone who helps us with the rebranding so we don't seem like OpenEdX and seem like Edera because we are Edera, not edX. So this is as simple as it. Yeah, our contacts, so Edera, it's edera.com and here, sorry about not being in English. We have this email address, info@edera.com. Yeah. Thank you very much. And yeah, we are going to expand and translate everything, and it will be very nice. We use a lot of open source, OpenEdX for courses, GitBook for library, and I hope that probably someday you will know us as something that you can learn from.
So one question is, or do I understand it correctly? It's a company, or
yes?
Is the because we also on the open source design job board we also have paid jobs. Would that be a paid job? Or would it be mostly like open source?
Sorry, we don't have money, we don't generate money because we are doing everything by ourselves. We try some grants now, so if we are able to get some grant, of course we would love to pay for a good job, but for now...
No, just asking because like if you haven't seen it on the jobs page, there's also some jobs with a price or... which are not just for free, so we actually try to make it also sustainable for designers to contribute.
Yes, of course.
One question, I guess the person that might get involved needs to speak.
Ukrainian?
Not necessarily. We, all of us speak English, Brazilian, yeah, and actually two of members of our team live in Berlin, so it's easy to communicate with us. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Next one.
That you have undeveloped, can you raise your hand? Okay, a lot of people, that's cool. Because I also have a lot of projects on GitHub, and there are either libraries that aim to be used by developers or end user products that are used. And for almost all of them, I like to get feedback from the people who use my products or my libraries or anything. And I realized that most of the time, people try to use it or want to use it, but they don't really do it, or they use it, but at some point they give up because there is something that is frustrating or that doesn't work for them. And I wish I could get that feedback, get them to tell me what's wrong with my projects. So most of the time I just give a link, can you submit an issue if there is something wrong, and I will try to help you. But a lot of people don't do it because they need to go to GitHub, create an account or log in with their account and, you know, think about what they need to write, and it takes some time. So I lose a lot of users just because there is no way to easily give some feedback. So as a developer, I realized that there were no option for customer support that would aim to be used by tech team, developers team. So I created a juicy.io, which you can use it, you have the URL to example. And it's a tiny widget that you add on your website or your presentation page if it's a library. And it's really just a very easy widget to use, and you just have a text box. And it's very similar to any other customer support widget, but this one will create an issue on GitHub, which means for you as a developer, you don't have to use an external tool and follow two things, your bug tracker and that tool that is going to be used by developers.
1 minute left. Yep. Do you need design help?
So as you can see, I'm really bad at using more than two colors. So most people are going like, oh, too much orange, I can't use your website. So I really need someone that can do design to have a better presentation of the project and, you know, use more than two colors. So if you're interested, just talk to me. There is in the photo as well. There's a contact us and meet the team and just in the style. Thank you.
Because we don't like we have until half past or so, but we can slightly longer maybe, but so there's no time for questions, just like next person come up. Do you want to do this? Everyone should get a chance. Yeah, again, let me know if you need help. I hope there's nothing bad in the history, but actually I don't care.
So we started a new project, the Onion project, and basically we want to do post-Snowden hosting. And there are many business models against privacy, criminals, targeted advertising, social graphic behavior and analysis, feature degradation by putting you behind a net router or using mandatory proxies, and government surveillance and censorship increasing everywhere on this planet. And post-Snowden, we think that we need to have encryption everywhere. anonymity network like Tor, and the new Tor service feature, which allows you to self-host services in the Tor network. And basically, we want to provide an operating system that's easy to install, has the full kitchen sink features available on a small computer like a Raspberry Pi, and we need a web user interface for configuration and using the thing. And then you can install blog forums or shop software on your own device in your own home, and it's behind the Tor network, and you are encrypted, anonymous, and hopefully secure. So there are many design challenges, the usual. The user needs to know what is happening in the device, why is it happening, how to achieve a certain goal, and how to correct a problem. But we also have unique challenges, because a mistake in the configuration can lead to de-anonymization, and that would be catastrophic. And Tor services exist in a parallel network. They're not accessible from the normal internet. You need a special client, or you use a proxy service, like OnionTO, and the security goals are abstract and difficult to communicate. And the user will not have a mental model when he talks. So he needs to actually get some mental model in the chat, how the thing works, so he can use it properly. And if you're in marketing, this doesn't work, but Bill Hicks has a quote, if you're in marketing, please kill yourself. And we are not that much interested in marketing, but we are interested in communication. And for communication, you need to design with intent. And we suck at this. We didn't even come up with a proper name, like Onion Project, what that's for a name. Like. And all over the shit. I did this on a weekend, and this is the second version. You don't want to see the first one. And this lies are horrible. And communicating with our users is going to be very difficult for us, because we are the technical experts, and our users have different problems. We don't understand what they're thinking. We don't understand how they use the thing. And we need a lot of help. We have a very small team. We have, if you want to work on this, you need some technical background in using Tor. Maybe understand what's at stake. The project has just started. And but we are experienced, and we help real people to be safe on the internet. And you can work on a new project today. Everything is open, so thank you. Then just come up and do it.
This is a very nascent project.
You forgot the dog. Or do you have that top level design?
Source clone of Cards Against Humanity. There are several design problems in this, in that you can't call it Cards Against Humanity, and that's a very terrible thing when you have no imagination. So you just start a GitHub project and you just go, this, and then you go, oh wait, that's terrible. So, yeah, one, I need a name. Two, it is okay the way it works. The idea is you just have a sort of, you start a server, local host, and then people join on your local Wi-Fi network and using their phones, and then they can see their hands and submit cards. But yeah, a apart from design help, it also needs development further than being able to just see your hand. And the way you can see your hand is not exactly the cleanest it could be. The way that everything is laid out has just grown organically, not with any particular thought over design. So what we really need is names, logos, any general sense of direction, and a good way to come up with an open source font that is similar enough to the Cosgate Humanity font that it is not illegal, but
Free Sans.
It looks good.
Free Sans. Because it's Helvetica, isn't it?
Sort of. Yeah, it's close. That's all I really have to say.
Just a general question, because, I mean, if you don't know, Cards Against Humanity is an existing card game, an actual, like, analog card game. So I'm wondering, like, except the name, are there not any, like, trademark or copyright issues with that?
So the only issue with it is you're allowed to completely use the game system. The only change you must make is that you are not allowed to call it Cards Against Humanity.
Okay.
So as long as you name it something completely different, that's fine.
The hackerspace in San Francisco, Noisebridge, made Noisebridge Against Humanity, and it looks exactly the same, and it just has like inside jokes, and
okay. They
sell them or whatever.
The idea of this was you could just start a local instance, and you could have your own deck manager, and just make your own set, and it's just adjacent.
Is it on some code platform?
It is on GitHub, and I will just...
So we just copy the slash before
Shift 7.
Hey,
so you can find the project here. Wonderful readme. Dependencies C requirements.txt. Awesome. So I hope I've interested someone in this terrible project, but good luck.
This happened to me before at Congress with your keyboard. I'm going to present a project that I'd love help on. It's very, very close to my heart. Some of my best friends in the world work on it. It's called Open Source Design.net. It's this website and this like community that we're all here. It kind of really came together last year at the Dev Room, which I wasn't at. And over the year, we've done, I think, a fair bit of stuff. We got a site going, we created this job board, but like as you can see, there's stuff like this isn't working, this isn't working. There's a bunch of jobs like we were looking at a few minutes ago, and it's like, you know, like it looks okay, but like come on, like there's job boards on the internet that you've seen, and they've got like icons and colors, and it's like really you can sort it maybe by categories and. You know, stuff like this, and you know, you go click on one of these, and it's like for something made by designers, you know, trying to connect to designers, I think it could be improved a little bit. That said,
more white space. That's white space.
We've got white space. Some people love it, some people hate it. You know, anyway.
Green birds, it's useful.
Yeah. This is what happened at Congress. Yeah. Okay. But. Basically, all the stuff that's happened so far on the site is like that exists for the community is because like someone will say, like, hey, let's meet up this Sunday for 4 hours and like try to do something. Let's have an IRC, WebRTC chat as a group. Let's create some issues. Let's like collaboratively work on stuff. We need more coder help. I'm a developer. Jan does some development. There's a handful of people. I don't know everybody's faces in the room. I'm sorry. But we need help of coders to like. Push this forward, and I think it's really important because, like,
making a community that is easily accessible for designers will get more designers to contribute to your open source projects. But if the designers like don't find it easy to engage with because the developers are on IRC, and this has been this ongoing debate about Slack versus IRC, and like a project that we've worked on some, I don't know.
You wanna,
yeah.
That's fine.
Okay, is making that, making a more usable IRC. But the whole site is just like these GitHub repos. It's kind of segmented, you can see, and they represent different sections of the website. Events, like for when we do hackathons or whatever, if you want to put a little event on. I kind of copy this idea from Node School. They do a really good job of this. You just like create a repo to represent your city, or you create a, you know, you create issues and tag people that you might want to come to your event. But we've done some cool stuff. It's a lot of it's just really a work in progress. Where's the logo thread? I want to show you guys that. Because that's one of the really cool things, like how we came up with this variation on the open source one. It was, can I keep going?
Yeah, just show
okay.
That one.
Is it there? Where is it? In here. Logos. Here we go. But see, this is like, it's one of the more beautiful collaborations I've seen online, especially with designers. You know, like some people started with this, then some people added a few variations, some people took that variation and remixed and added colors, this one was introduced, there's another remix, some other variations. Just, it was really, really collaborative and cool to see it come together. I was like in the hospital for most of the thread site. I was out of sync. I'm so happy with the result. I think it's lovely. And if the person who did it, did the one that got picked ultimately, please introduce yourself. I'd love to meet you. We ultimately voted on it. So we were really trying to be as like inclusive and sharing. We just need to really throw ideas in the pot, try it out, like make a mistake, do a rough draft, like just anything. Just contribute something to the group. And I don't know, I don't think we need an issue for that. There's a whole website that needs improvement. Thank you.
Okay, like technically the time is over, but if anyone really wants to present their project, you're very welcome to. Otherwise, we can just basically wrap it up, I guess. I hope, I don't even know what to say. So go to opensourcedesign.net, check out what everyone's doing. Next year, I hope we'll do it again, the dev room, maybe in a bigger room, because part of the day was pretty crowded. Thanks to Belen and Bernard and
John.
Yeah, everyone else as well, Katarina, who participated. Cool. Thanks a lot.